Hello, hello, my friends. How are you doing over there? Welcome. Today's lesson, we are going to do some literature and we are going to focus on this book, Blossoms of the Savannah from the Maa culture. We are going to analyze it, the themes and the stylistic devices. Okay, before we go to the themes and the stylistic devices, I'm going to give you a brief overview of chapter 1 summary. And chapter 1 is about relocation from Nakuru to Nasila, and the Kailos family is moving from Nakuru town to Nasila, and this family consists of four members, that is Parsimei Ole Kailo, Mama Milanoi, and their daughters Tayo and Resian. They are moving from Nakuru to Nasila because Ole Kailo has been retrenched from the Agribix Limited, where he has been working for more than 20 years. And the book opens with Tayo standing in the window watching what is happening in Nakuru town. And later on we find Parsimei Ole Kailo supervising the loading of the furniture into the lorries. Okay, let us now move to the themes, and we are going to focus on the themes in chapter 1, and we have these four. And the first theme is the theme of tradition, and tradition in chapter 1 is presented in two ways. And the first way is polygamy. Most of the men in Nasila are polygamous, and we find Uncle Simiren. He has four wives and 16 children. And the second way is through female genital mutilation. When girls in Maasai land or in Nasila reach a certain age, they are supposed to undergo the cut. And that is why the two daughters of Ole Kailo, that is Tayo and Resian, are being referred as Intoye Nemengalana, which means uncircumcised girls, because at their age, they are supposed to have undergone the cut, but they have not. Theme number two, the theme of change. The book opens with the family moving from Nakuru town to Nasila, and there is that change from an urban setup to a rural setup. We also have cultural change. The culture is changing. For instance, the two girls are supposed to have undergone the cut, but at that age, they have not undergone the cut. Okay, the theme of love. And love is that strong feeling of affection towards someone or something. And we find this love, the theme of love, on page 9. We are told that Ole Kailo loved Mama Milanoi from the moment that he saw her at church, and 22 years later, he is still obsessed to Mama Milanoi. The theme of education. And from the book, the two Ole Kailo's daughters have been educated and they have completed their secondary school education. Resian is also determined to study. She wants to join the Egerton University and she wants to pursue a course in veterinary science. She wants to become a veterinary doctor. And now let us move to the stylistic devices. And these are the styles that are evident in chapter 1. Vivid description. And we have two characters who are described in chapter 1. And the first one is Mama Milanoi on page 9. We are told that her breasts are full and heavy. Her waist slender. Her hips are big and seductively curved. The second character who is described in chapter 1 is Lenjir on page 3. And Lenjir is Tayo's boyfriend in Nakuru. Lenjir is described as lanky, dark-haired, blunt-faced, and with big, lunged eyes. Local dialect. And many words from the Maasai culture or from the Maasai language are used in the book. And the first word we have, papai, it means father. We also have yeyo, and yeyo means mother. We have olkunchai, and that means cattle trader. We also have intoye nemengalana, which means uncircumcised girls. Irony, and in simple words, irony is the opposite of what we expect, and it is evident on page 10. It is ironic for a parent to dislike or to hate their own baby or their own child. And we are told that Ole Kailo detested Resian the moment that she was born. And what was the reason behind that? It's because he was expecting a baby son. to be the heir of the family. Dialogue, and dialogue is a conversation between two or more people. We have dialogue in page 2 and 3, and that is the dialogue between Preciano and Tayo, and they are talking about how life is gonna be in Nasila. And guys, that is the end of our lesson today. I hope you enjoyed the lesson. In case you have any questions, shoot me on the comment section. And in case there is any other stylistic device or any other theme that is evident, please let me know.